Hello and welcome to Chapter 2, Tutorial 4. We're going to create a vertex buffer. Sorry. So, all this to try to create a triangle, basically. So, let's create a new class, right? So we can hold our triangle in it. So, let's call triangle.page and we're going to create triangle.cpp. All right. Here it is. Right, and we have our CPP there. Right, and we're going to include our renderer here. Right, create a public constructor. And we're going to receive the renderer as parameter because we're going to need to access the device's context and device to kind of create a resource and stuff. And same thing with a draw function. So let's right away put a draw function here. Renderer. All right. And later on, we're going to have private stuff here. Okay. Let's quickly implement those functions. So far, I'm not doing anything that we haven't seen yet, just creating basic constructor and a function and passing something by reference, right? Now let's go in our main and let's create an instance of that triangle. All right, so let's create a triangle here, let's call it triangle, and let's pass our renderer to it. Yeah, and you have to include it. This is what's a little bit annoying with C++. You have to include, even if it's part of the project, you always have to include it for the file you're working in. So, you know, like in C#, like if it's part of your project or the namespace, you never have to basically include it. Okay, so triangle, and then in somewhere here, you know, remember where we said we would render all of our wool and stuff, where we're going to draw our triangle in there. Wonderful. Oh, and yeah, we need to pass the renderer to it because it's going to need the device context to do so. All right, quickly compiling, see if it compiles. I will say with Visual Studio 2013, IntelliSense got so good that you see in red right away when you do mistakes. So I basically never end up with compiler errors anymore because of this. It's really useful. All right, so we create a triangle in our main and we call a function. So we don't have to deal with the main anymore. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're actually going to create the triangle here. All right, so what's defining a triangle? Well, triangle is like the basic geometry that's rendered by DirectX and also OpenGL if you use OpenGL. I know in OpenGL you have options like say, well, I want quads instead of triangle. But they're basically just being converted into triangle into the driver, right? So it's all triangles, and triangles consist of three points, right? I don't have to teach you basic high school math here. So it's three points, and you have to define those points where they are in the screen, and basically the order in which you render them, like clockwise or counterclockwise, are going to determine if it's the front of the triangle or the back of the triangle. So let's define one of those triangle points, right? Let's call this a vertex. So we're going to declare a small structure here, small type that's going to hold our vertex information for the triangle. So we're going to have XY, right? It's going to be in 2D on the screen. Basically, it's going to do something like this. We're going to have XY, and we're going to have a different color at each point. So we're going to have RGB. So I didn't show you yet that way of declaring variables, but this is the same thing as doing float X, float Y. You can just declare them like that. So it doesn't change absolutely anything. It just makes prettier to see and understand. All right, so yeah, so define our vertices. This is a vertex, this is a plural, vertices, all right. So we're going to define an array of three vertex because we have 3 points, 1, 2, and 3. So we already know how to create an array. So let's do this. Let's define our first vertex, which is going to be, so basically the screen, how it works, here, the bottom left, it's going to be -1, -1, and the top right, it's going to be 1, 1, and the center, it's 0, 0, right? So if you just render everything at 0, 0, it's going to be in the center of the screen, basically. So we want the first points to be here, so -1, -1, and let's make that color red. Right, let's copy that 3 times. And the next vertex is going to be at the top here. So in X, it's going to be in the middle, so 0. And it's Y, it's going to be at 1 in the top. So let's put 0 and 1. And the last one, oh, and let's put this one green. Sorry, this one was red, this one was green. This one will be blue. And this one is going to be at 1 and -1. Right, so we've defined the vertices of our triangle. So you can make this a more complex mesh, you can make a quad, you can make a full character, you know, and you can define way more properties than this eventually. You can put a Z value there eventually. We're just sticking to the basic 2D for now. All right, so we have defined our vertices. Now we're going to create our vertex buffer. So a vertex buffer, it's basically, we're going to take this, and you can just render in DirectX 11 with this. Like you could do it in the previous DirectX. And that's called basically kind of imitate mode, I think. You can't do this anymore. You need to take this and put it somewhere in the video card memory. So we don't really have access to video card memory, right? Right now this is in the CPU, in your motherboard memory, the RAM, and you want to put that in the VRAM. So you're going to basically create a vertex buffer or just a buffer object that's in DirectX, and the drivers will basically put that in your video memory. And that way, after that, the video card, when it's rendering this, it has basically a very fast access to it because it's right sitting in the memory beside it. So that's why it's done this way. And that's why right now they kind of force you to do it this way. You can just do imitate because they don't want you to write a shitty program anymore that runs slow. Okay, so create our vertex buffer. All right, so we need first to define the descriptor. So remember what we were doing here with the swap chain. We were defining some kind of description. We were doing the same thing with our window here. We kind of have to do the same thing with our buffer. Luckily, we have a function that's going to help us build it, and it's called C. The C stands for constructor, so construct a D3D11, Direct3D11 buffer descriptor. All right, and there's a couple version of it, and we're going to use this one. So the first parameter is basically the size of our data, right? So how big is this? So each float is basically 4 byte, 32 bits, and there's 5 of them, so that's 20 byte. And then there's 3 of them, so that should be about 60 byte total. So, you know, I could have put like just 60 here, but you don't want to do the math, so you can use a C++ function, which is called sizeof. I think it is actually a C function. So you just put your vertices in there, and voila. So this should technically return 60 for you, right? It will calculate the size of it, and it's doing that at compile time, so it's when it's compiling the program, it's going to put 60 there. Awesome. The second one is the bind flags. So basically, you want to tell DirectX what this is. Let's do a return here. Well, it's a D3D11 bind vertex buffer, because you can have an index buffer. Okay, it's not just a vertex buffer. And there are different type of buffers too. There's constant buffer, the shared array buffer. We will see that in further tutorials. But the most frequent ones are basically vertex buffer and index buffer. We're not going to render with index buffers in most of our tutorials. That might be enough series tutorial. I don't want to bother you with that. It's certainly faster to render with index buffer, but we'll get to this maybe in the future. All right, So, and the next one is the no, basically we're done. You don't have to define more stuff. The default parameter would take whatever you want next. So we have our description. Okay, it's pretty short. And then we want to create the vertex data. So the data we're going to send to the VRAM. We need to basically that's a pointer. Okay, an array is a pointer. That's the data we want to send. So we need to pass that through a kind of DirectX structure. It's called Direct3D11 sub resource data. All right, vertex data. Let's initialize to zero. So again, this is kind of a descriptor again. And you just one things you want set in it is the system memory. All right, you want it to point to this. So with those two information, DirectX now knows, well, it's pointing on this memory, and it's going to be the size of 16. So now it knows where to take it, and then it can push it to the video card, and then we don't care anymore where it sits. All right, so that's how we create our descriptor to create our vertex buffer. Now we're going to create the actual vertex buffer. So remember, we need the device to create resource. So we're going to actually add a function here to get it because we can't get it right now. Right, so get device. Let's create one for device context because we will need that later to render. Because remember that those are private members, so you don't have directly access to them. I want to return the device. And here I want to return the device context. All right. Now we can continue here. So what we want is the renderer we pass in parameter here. Let's get the device. And with it, we're going to create a buffer. All right. So the descriptor for the perfect for the buffer, it's what we've defined here. Then the other is the initial data. So I don't think you have to actually put initial data here because you can create just an empty buffer and say you upload it later. But in our case, we just want to create a buffer and never touch it again. Sorry, this is red. Why? Oh, it wants a pointer. This is not a pointer. Okay, so just give him the address. Wonderful. And then they want basically a pointer on your result. So I don't think we haven't created it. So it's an interface Direct3D11 buffer. All right. So basically, you can always like just ignore that part, and it's just a buffer. You can see it this way. And this is going to be our vertex buffer. Let's initialize to null. And you want a pointer on this. And this should create our vertex buffer, basically. So if I run this, let's make sure it doesn't crash. So it's probably creating it. Let's put a breakpoint. And yeah, the address has changed, so it's not null anymore. So it actually worked. Again, like all of those functions return, as you can see there below my mouse, it returns a hash result. So remember what we did here. We actually test for errors. You can do this and try to be good and do this in everywhere in your program. For cleanness of the tutorial, I'm not doing this. There's multiple reasons why it could fail. Maybe there's no memory, video memory available anymore, or stuff like this. Or you've done an error in one of the parameters here. That can happen. All right. So now we want to draw it. It is not going to work, but we can bind and try to draw it, but it's not going to draw anything because we're missing two more tutorials to actually see the triangle on the screen, unfortunately. This is where I think DirectX 11 and the new OpenGL frameworks kind of turn off newbies to this because you have so many steps just to try to render one thing. And if you make a mistake in one of those states, in one of those steps, it's really hard to find what you did wrong, and you can pass days just trying to render one single triangle. So it's pretty annoying. I got the experience of doing it frequently, and I have to tell you, when I wrote that tutorial, it didn't work the first time. So I had to install a tool to actually go in and debug and see my vertex data in my video memory and see what's going on, and then finally it actually worked. Yeah, but if you follow this tutorial, it's going to work. So if you're in doubt, just check that. If something doesn't work, just send me an email. I will assist you. All right, the emails is in the description as usual. All right, so let's continue here. So first of all, before rendering, all right, we need to bind our vertex buffer. So why we need to bind it and not just like pass it for every call you're doing, draw call, it's basically you can bind it once and render multiple triangles, right? So let's say you're in Call of Duty and everyone in your team has the exact same character mesh. Well, they're going to bind it once and then they're going to render your whole team, and they're going to be like draw calls for eight of your team without rebinding the memory in the video card. So it's actually very optimized to do it this way. So that's why it's like that. We're going to need two things first. All right, the first one is stride. So this is unsigned integer, right? This is a type. We saw that previously, I think, in the window proc here. If you were wondering this is, if you just go to definition, you see that it's just a type def for an unsigned int, right? This is a uint it's right on uint there. So they kind of, most API like to redefine their types all the time like that. I find that a little bit annoying, but that's because depending on the platform you are, some types kind of change in size, and it's really annoying. This is how C++ kind of is. But I will encourage you to always use basic types in your projects. But when you have no choice, like right now we were calling a DirectX function, so you kind of want to use their type. But under the hood, it's just a normal int, okay? So the stride is the size between each vertex. Right, DirectX will need to know this because when it's rendering your first triangle, you just gave him a buffer of floats, basically. That's how it sees it. It's just seeing a buffer, and it needs to know, okay, when I'm done rendering that point, I want to go to the next one, how much I have to move in the memory. So you just give him the size of your structure here, which will end up probably being 20. You know, we can put a breakpoint and see what it is. And you can see it's 20, stride 20. So you need to define that every time you bind a vertex buffer, and you need to tell him the offset. So offset is basically, well, I don't want to start basically at the first, that's the offset between each structure, I think. Anyway, just put it to zero. You're probably never going to use any of this. Those things get useful when you start rendering like shadow map and stuff like that. So when you render a shadow map, you render your whole scene, just the depth, and basically the information for the depth you don't need the color, so you just care about that part, right? So you're going to skip that part so you can put an offset and different stride and stuff. All right, I'm getting too deep there. We will see that later, I guess, in a of Siri tutorial. So we want to get the device context here because we actually do render stuff. Here we were using the device to create a resource and the device context to render stuff. I'm repeating that a lot, I know, but it's important. It's important to know the difference. and we want to set the vertex buffer. So input assembler set vertex buffer. All right, the start slot is the first. Just always put zero there. The number of buffer that we're passing in is just one. Like, you can bind multiple buffer at once, right? So that's useful. They want a pointer on your vertex buffer, so pass the address of it. And then they want a pointer on your stride, and they want a pointer on your offset. So the reason why they want pointer there is because you can pass more than one vertex buffer. And in this case, if you pass two, well, this will probably be an array. Oops. Then this will be an array. Then you can remove the address. It's a pointer by default. So But don't worry for this right now. But this is the reason why they actually want pointer. There is actually reasons for this. It's not just weird code. All right, so that's how you bind it. So you'll see here there's IE. This means input assembler. So let's just quickly go into DirectX 11 pipeline stages. All right, so this is what's going on in the video guard. Just going quickly through this, but basically this is the input assembler you can see here, stage. Then there's the vertex shader stage, right? And then later on there's distillation and stuff. And later on here, the other one we care about is going to be the pixel shader. Then it goes in output merger, and this will merge the result of your pixel to basically the frame buffer. An input assembler is all that you've set up, like the vertex buffer and whatnot. So when we refer to a specific stage, you will see that in this case we use IIA, I mean. And when we will do vertex shader stuff, it's going to start with VS. When we do pixel shader stuff, it's going to start with PS. And when we like set up the blending mode, for example, this is done at the end. It's blending your final pixel to the buffer. It's going to be output merger. It's going to be OM set blending, for example. All right. So don't worry if you see those weird letters there at the top of certain function in the Vi context. It's all referred to which stage it is. All right. So let's close this. I'm actually going pretty deep in this tutorial and explanation, and I'm not doing so many line of code. But I think it's cool to know those things. It's you know what you're doing right now. Then we're going to draw it. So we've bound it, as I explained earlier, and then you can just draw as many of you want. So we're going to draw only once. How many vertices we have? We have three, and we want to start at the first vertices. And that's it. That's how you draw a triangle. You bind the buffer and you draw it. And that's it. Like the data we created there, we just created in the function. It gets destroyed after. We don't need this in the RAM anymore. And as promised. All right, so I had to restart the video here. So don't run this, you will kill your drivers. All right, so because we're not actually done setting up the things, it couldn't find a vertex shader and stuff, and it literally crashed my video card. Well, Windows 7, this is Windows 7, it's actually smart enough to recover from this. So the video stopped, and that's pretty much what happened. If you're on Windows XP, you probably got a blue screen at that point. So, so basically, don't run this. We've set up it to draw. You can try to compile it, and it would be fine. So we've set up the vertex buffer, and we're drawing it. And that's it. So we're going to see how to do vertex and pixel shader in the next tutorial, and then we'll be able to actually draw something without crashing the video card. All right, so thanks for watching. See you in the next tutorial.